had an idea for a small game, so I quickly made this prototype. We got a guy with a bow that rotates from side to side, and you're able to shoot arrows by tapping on the bottom part of the screen. On the touch area, we got a pointer down event that triggers a fire bow method in our player script. We get an available arrow from an arrow dispenser class that pulls arrows, and then we fire and reload our bow. All the while, we're smoothly rotating from one side to the other and change the direction once we reach the max angle. Very simple, but it's enough for a small game like this. So the actual idea for the game is that you're standing on a castle wall and enemies attack in waves. You gotta take them out before they reach you, and when you're inevitably overrun, the game ends and the amount of kills you got becomes your score. An arcade high score game, basically. I'll code the enemy spawning and movement logic now, and also implement the hit detection for the arrows. Enemies are now spawning and they can also be killed. I tweaked the player controls some more because I had an idea for the bow to be reloaded only once the player reached the max rotation angle, and long story short, I decided it was too complicated, so I'm reverting back to the old controls instead. I did a quick little sketch here for how I want the characters to be shaped. I'm going for a very cartoony look since I think it will best fit a more casual game like this one. I ended up making some kind of a swole Legolas character, and I honestly wish I would have thought this through a bit better, because now I'm gonna have to shoehorn in some elves versus orcs scenario into this game, or maybe I'll just texture a shirt onto his torso and change his hair or something. Either way, I've gone ahead and animated him with a bow and arrow here, and I'm ready to bring him into the game as soon as I've made the environment. I want the player to stand on a castle wall and the enemies to appear on the horizon. They'll climb over these rocks before running towards you. So I'll make the first draft of the environment and see later what I'll have to change, because there will inevitably be some issues with what I'm creating here. Alright, so I brought the character into the game and also changed the camera to orthographic mode. I haven't decided if I'll change it back to a very tight perspective camera later or if I'll keep it this way, but I'm liking the way it looks so far. But there are a few issues. First of all, I realized that it will take too long for me to make these rocks here look good and make the enemies appear behind them and climb over them. So I'm just gonna extend the grass all the way to the top. However, this will cause the map to look very dull, especially with this grass texture. So I'm gonna have to add some flowers and other details to make it more interesting. Then finally, I forgot to actually model the other side of the wall here at the bottom of the screen. So I'll take care of all those things now, and then I'll start working on the enemies. Alright, I'm low on time and out of ideas, so I'll go for the orc enemy option. I'll remove the hair from the player character and turn his skin green. Give him a huge sword and animate him. By the way, here's how you do a quick run animation. Create the key poses for the contact, passing, and in-air frames. Repeat back to the first frame. Make sure the hip is moving up and down, and that the supporting leg touches the ground when it should. Everything else is basically just smoothing out and tweaking the curves. I did the last remaining animations needed for the orc and brought him into the game. I made it so that they jump up on the wall when they are in range. Now all I gotta do is to make it so that the game ends when that happens. And for that, I need some UI. I decided for a name and got my girlfriend to make a simple logo again, just like she did for Boomer Simulator. If you haven't seen that video, then go check it out. Castle Master Bow and Arrow Defense, aka keywords the game. I was originally pretty optimistic about this project because I thought that for a casual mobile game, it had potential. I guess it still has, considering all the shit that is on the stores nowadays. I mean, some of these top games don't even have sound. Speaking of which, I reused some sounds that I made in the past for Gladihoppers and made it so that you continuously fire arrows instead of having the game be about timing and precision, which it was before. My point is, while playing this game, I quickly got bored of it. The new, faster gameplay that the changes I made brought made things a bit better, but still not fun. And that makes the game difficult to work on, since so much of game development is based on feeling good about what you're doing, especially in the early stages. I'm not entirely sure where it went wrong, but I'm going to leave things like this for now. Maybe I'll come back to it in the future once I've had some time away from it. Anyway, thanks for watching the video, have a good day, and I'll see you next time. Bye bye.